It's an honor and a privilege to introduce Bilan Arte, the Canadian Federation of Students Manitoba Chair. Thank you for being with us today.
Canadian Federation of Students Manitoba. Our organization represents over 44,000 post-secondary students at every single university in our province, and I'm proudly and pleased to be here today in my pink scarf and my pink shirt. The importance of this campaign can never be overemphasized for our members. It works to promote inclusive campuses and ensure that these spaces remain positive and supportive learning environments for students to grow as leaders and to develop and shine. We know the reality of bullying today is not confined to playground trysts, and it's time that we busted that myth. We know that our students are facing adversity and discrimination as an everyday experience on campuses, whether that be in classrooms, in hallways, or in residences, as well as in their communities, on the streets, and even in their homes. And yet, too often, we hear this anecdote that Crystal had mentioned, "Sticks and stones may break our bones, but words will never hurt us." And it's repeated as a way to silence and shame us as victims. However, we have those very lived experiences and testaments to the contrary, that in fact words can, do, and have hurt us, often to the point where we are left feeling incredibly alone and facing the worst. It's in spite of this reality and in honor of all of the lives that have sadly been lost throughout this struggle, that our fight against bullying, our fight against harassment and discrimination in any form must continue and stand strong. In this spirit, I'd like to thank today's organizers, all the students that have been organizing from coast to coast in our country today, our provincial government for being such leaders, and every single one of you that has come out here today in support of this cause. The strength and dedication that we see in this room tells me that we are building a movement, and I'm honored to join those ranks. The work is still ahead of us. It's a long road. But let's appreciate every milestone today as a victory towards a discrimination-free tomorrow. Thank you.